Good afternoon, viewers. Now, welcome to Better Faith e-learning platform. My name is Ms. Blessing. I'll be taking your basic science on GSS2. Last week, we talked about energy, power, and work, or work, energy, and power. And we did some calculations, and I believe you've done those practice exercises. Today, we'll be talking about thermal energy. Talk about energy. Thermal energy. The first question is, what is thermal energy? Thermal energy, what about energy that has to do with? When we say thermal, thermal means heat. Another word for thermal is what? Heat, thermal energy. Thermal energy, or it's also called heat energy, is a form of energy which tends to move from one place to another, especially from its source, from a hot source to a cooler area. When we say thermal energy, it means ability for there's a transfer of energy from a hot surface to a cooler surface. That is what thermal energy. When we say thermal energy, it means it's also called heat energy. It means when heat flows from a hot area to a cold one, heat can flow through solid and what and liquid materials. For example, you boil water, there's heat flow in that boiling. Heat flows from the stove to the pot and then to the water. Like the sun, when the sun radiates sunlight. We feel the warmness, that's what, so a form of thermal energy, that's thermal energy. So we have different, various ways heat can be flow. How does this heat flow? We have different ways in which heat can flow or heat can be transferred. The first way heat can flow is what? It's conductor. We have three ways, take note, three major ways heat can transfer or heat can flow from one state of matter to another. The first one is conduction. It's called conduction. When we say conduction, what does this mean? Conduction is the ability or is a movement. It's a movement of solid particles. The movement of heat in solid particles through materials without any obvious movement. It's a movement of heat through solid particles. Without any obvious movement, which call the what a conductor. The movement of heat of in a solid particle. Remember, the word solid. What talk about conductor? It involves solid materials. Movement of heat through a solid material without any obvious movement. For example of what materials that conduct heat, they are referred to as what? They are conductors. Any material that can conduct heat. I can transform it and refers to what was conductors. Example of a conductor is found in the metal pots. So, and remember I said the best conductor of heat is what? Their metal. Last week I said it. Metals conduct heat easily. So when you boil water, for instance, in a stove, the heat transfer from the stove to the pots and from the pots to the water. That transfer, the pot itself, the middle object, the pot between the heat and the liquid of which is heated is called what? That material is called what? A conductor. So that mental pot is the conductor. It is the platform that conducts heat from the stove to the water. So that's for conduction. Ability to conduct heat. Ability to the movement of heat from a water in a through a solid material without any obvious movement. For instance, when you see the wire in an electric pole, the wire is made up of copper and it's solid. So it's what it will say a wire is a good conductor, a copper wire is a good conductor of what? Of heat and electricity. When, for instance, you put your spoon in the fire, for instance, the tip of the spoon becomes hot. When you put your hand in the other part, for example, you hit this part of the spoon. And this other part, you touch this other part. At a time, gradually the heat is transferred from this place where you start the heat to the tip here. That's what, because the metal helps to conduct the heat to the other side. So it's heat transfers easily in a metal object. What about convection? When we say convection, it's a movement of heat through liquid medium, liquid and gas medium. It's a method of transfer of heat in liquid and gases. Liquid and gases. Why conduction? As I said before, it's for solid material. Convection is for liquid and gases. The transfer of heat convey from one part of a liquid to or gas to another. Another part by movement of what? Molecules. You know, the liquid, for instance, contains molecules. They contain atoms and molecules. So when heat passes to those, to the liquid, the movement of this molecule, if there is movement in this molecule, it becomes freer. Not so solid though, because it's liquid, it's still in the medium. It becomes freer, freer than the gas, than the solid molecule. Even for gases, it's even move faster in gases than in liquid. So when this heat transfer from those liquid medium, it's called what? It's called convection. So know the difference. It's called convection. For conduction, it's from solid material. Why for convection is from both liquid and gaseous material. What about radiation? When we say radiation, radiation is a form of energy. So the last one, radiation, it is the means by which heat energy travels to the sun across this outer space to reach the Earth surface. When we say radiation, it occurs in a vacuum. It always happens in a vacuum. No air, no liquid, not gases and liquid. In a vacuum space, in an open space. For example, the sun is passing through what? The sun radiates from the sky down to the atmosphere through radiation. So for example, when you sit close to your window, you feel the heat in the window. That's radiation. There's no medium involved in radiation. There's no solid medium or liquid medium. There's no medium at all involved in radiation. You only feel it within you. But that's when you on your electricity bulb. The heat that the electricity bulb radiates, you feel it within you. You don't need to touch it before you start feeling the heat. So that's what radiation is, which means the heat is radiating from the electric bulb down to your body. So that's for the radiation. The rate at which the body absorbs heat or radiates heat depends on its temperature. The rate at which a body radiates heat from a surface or from a vacuum depends on the temperature of that body, depends on the material the body is made of, and it depends on the area of its surface. So take note, the rate at which a body radiates or absorbs heat is crude to the frame it is by, it depends on three medium. It depends on one, the temperature, it depends on the material that it is made of, and it depends on the area of its surface. Heat can be transmitted through empty space by radiation. It always occurs in what? In empty space. So that's for radiation. So take note, conduction is in solid material, convection is in liquid and gas material, while radiation is an open space in a vacuum. When we say vacuum, vacuum is an open space. It's in, there's no air, no liquid, no gas. It happens in an empty space. So heat traveling through radiation does not need what? Any medium, which that solid gases or liquid medium to travel through. Heat travels through a vacuum. What is a vacuum? I told you before, I said a vacuum is a space in which there's nothing at all, not even air. In a vacuum, there's vacuum in space between the Earth and the Sun. The heat from the Sun travels down to the Earth through what? A vacuum to the Earth. So those are the three different means through which heat can be transferred. So you know when you go on leisure, you go to read more on it in the textbook. Example of the conduction materials that conduct heat in practical use is when you have the wire gas. We have the wire gas, we have mineral safety lamp. So those are examples of a conductor. Those are solid materials in which heat can be transferred. Why for convection, which is for liquid and for gases? Example is where we have the hot water supply. Hot water supply, when you boil water, the liquid inside is called what? A convection. Then we have a chimney. We have chimney and we have a radiator. You can find a radiator in the vehicle. It's an example of a convection. It convects it from the source to the car. Then why for radiation, we have the refrigerator, we have the air condition. So all those are the radiates heat from the air condition. So in your leisure, please go to your textbook, read more on it, thermal energy. And read the major thing you need to know about thermal energy is the medium of what? Of transfer, how they transfer energy